tutorial, I will show you how to create a block like this. I will start from the previous exercise. Maybe you notice that the look of the strategy is a little bit different. And now I'm using a new version of C Suite. It uses different colors for the variables according to the data type. Green for variable in retain and blue for not retain. In the previous exercise, we used the FBD, so the whole strategy was written in FBD, function block diagram. In the next exercise, we will move this strategy, the one managing the four stages, we move in a block where the strategy inside is written in ST, in structured text, using basic statements like if, then, else, and if, and so on. There are two types of objects that we can use, function and function block. They are POU, program organization unit, like programs. To choose the right object, we have to see what are the features of these two objects. This slide summarizes the feature, but I prefer to see the next one. The first is a function. This is the definition of function by the standard IEC 61131. So the main features are a function can have zero or more inputs. Okay, also the other type of block is the same. And then can have one output and only one output. And in case of user function like this, the name of the output is the name of the function. They can have a local variable to support the strategy inside, but in contrast to the other type of block, the function block, the local variable are not stored. This means that the block can't remember the value of input, output, and local variable of the previous program cycle. Since there is no memory of what happened before, the function produces the same result for the same value of input. The most known function are the arithmetical operator, like the addition. 1 plus 3 is returns always 4. The square root of a number, for example 16, is always 4. The average of a set of variable is always the same. So, same output for the same input. How to use a function? It is simple, just use it in a FBD POU. Just drag and drop the function into the page. You will see the direct with the name of the function. In ST language, just type the name and the input between parentheses. That's it. The other type of block is the function block. This is the definition by the standard. The main features. A function block has zero or more input, like the other block. A function block has zero or more output. This is different compared to the other block, because the other can have just one. This has two, this has just one, this has four. A function block can have local variable, but in contrast to the other block, the function, the local variable are stored. So each use of a function has its own set of input, output, local variable. So since the variable are different, a function block can remember the value of the variable of the previous program cycle, as well as they can be different from other use of the same function block. And for this reason, they can produce different outputs for the same input. A typical function block is a timer, like the timer on, where the output can be false or true depending on the time. If the elapsed time is less than the present time is false, else it is true. And for an hysteresis block, the output can be false or true according if the input is around the set point and the input is increasing or decreasing. Well, a function block, in order to have the ability to remember the value of the input of the previous program cycle, needs an instance. So before to use a function block, we have to create an instance. What is an instance? An instance like isTerAddVarial1234 basically is a copy of a data type. Also variables like water inlet temperature, set point temperature, proportional band, compressor 1234 are instances of a data type. The difference is that while in this case they are instances of an elementary data type, real and bool, isTerAddReal is a derived data type, and to be more precise, it is a structure which fields are the input and the output and the local variable, if any, of the function block. So isTerAddReal123 are instances of the type isTerAddReal, that is a structure, and it is possible to directly address the fields of the structure just adding as prefix the name of the instance. For example, in this case we assign to a variable the value of the field out of the instance isTerAddReal1. Well, so an instance basically is a copy. It is an independent structure, so four instances for a structure, associated to an algorithm that reads and writes the fields of the structure. Well, what kind of block do we have to use here? Function or function block? In this case, there is no choice. We must use function block for two reasons. The first, the block has four outputs. Second reason, the block has to save the status of four stages that depend on the previous value of or the trend of the input and the previous value of stage. And only function block can have more outputs, two or more outputs, and then can save the previous values of the variable. So we must use function block. Here are the four steps to create a function or a function block. Step 1, we have to create a new function or function block, so right click, add, select the language. I told you that in this exercise I want to use structured text. By the way, you can see that each function block can use any of these four languages, exactly like the program PO. So you can freely mix these four languages among program, PO, and function and function block PO. So new function block, structured text. Step 2, we have to rename, it's not mandatory but recommended, rename the function block with a more significant name, like stage 4 direct. Next, step 3, we have to create the inputs and the output of the function block. There are two ways to do it. The first is right click and parameters. In one tool were called pins, here are called parameters. Also this window can be docked where you want. So this button to create inputs, just one, cancel. This one to create the outputs, we can rename to in data type real because it uses the output of a comReal block. Comment not mandatory but recommended. Dimension is for array, but we don't need array. Okay, the output, the first is called or could be called stage 1. Data type boolean is good because it is a status of the stage. And now we can see that we can create a local variable, but in this case, in this exercise, we don't need of them. So we can see the other way to create a parameter, that is using the local variables of this PO. Here are the existing one. In a stage one are an input and output, the other are local variable. So we have to create a stage 2, 3, 4 that are output. I already show you that in the list of variable there is the quick declaration. that allows you to create very quickly variables. So stage 1 is already exists, so from 2 to 4 prefix stage, data type boolean is good, direction these are outputs. Okay, I can sort. So in is an input, stage 1, 2, 3, 4 are output, var 1, 2, 3, 4 are local variable, so we don't need them, so I can delete. When you modify the local variables, also the parameter change, here are, and vice versa, when you add a parameter here, the local variable is updated. You can change the sequence of the parameter of the parameter here with a simple drag and drop. So stage 1 at the beginning, stage 1, 2, 3, 4. Very well. Next and the last step, we have to write the code. So double click the PoE. So we selected the ST language, so it open a simple text box where we can type the statements. So we have to check if the input is greater than 25, and in that case switch on the stage 1, else if it is less than or equal 0, and switch off the stage 1. Remember that we are writing the code inside this function block, so we have to read this input and write this output. Read in and write stage 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you don't know the syntax of ST language, you can use the toolbox, drag and drop the statement. If in this case it plays a template of the statement, and then can simply replace the comments with an expression in this case. So we have to check if the input in is greater than or equal 25.0, because it is a real value, you remember? Then what? Then the output stage 1 is becomes true. Else or else if. In this case we need the else if, because we have to check another expression. If the input is less than or equal 0, then what, then stage 1 is or becomes false. No else, delete, I can add a comment start with parentheses asterisk stage number 1 and comments ends with the star asterisk. Let's check if this is correct. If the input greater than 25, true, less than 0, false. Greater than 25, true, less than 0, false. Okay, we can simply copy and paste the code. So stage number 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, and 4. Now change the thresholds. This is 50 and ends 25. Third starts 75 to 50, the last starts at 100 and ends 75. Okay, we can check here the values. You see, I'm reading in and writing stage 1, 2, 3, and 4. Reading in and writing stage 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, it's all. So I have created a new function, or better, a function block. I have renamed it. I defined the input and the output of the function block, and then write the code inside. Now I can replace the code in the exercise. So I can delete the previous strategy, so delete. In the block library, I should find a new library with the name of the project, here is Chiller, with our new stage 4 direct. If you have the Solution Explorer on the screen, we can also do this. Here, let's compact. Arrows. Well, it's finished. Now we can test. Okay, I have to reopen the toolbar with the arrows here. So I can simulate. Remember that when you change this property, you have to rebuild. Okay, complete. Start simulation. This is a known issue. This is always a warning that there is a mismatch between the current version of the software in editing and the one in the controller. So till we fix that problem, you can just answer no. If you are sure that you will not change, you can answer no. Okay, set point 12, band 4, temperature. So 12.9, expect still off, fact. 13, first step. 14, the second. 15, the third. Here is, and 16, the last. Here is. Go down. 15. Little mistake. 15. Okay. 3, 14. 2, 13, and 12. So, well, the function block works exactly as we expect. But let's suppose that it doesn't work as we want. So, how to troubleshoot it? So, we can see how to use breakpoints, that is, stop the program over this function, over this block, and enter inside it. To use the breakpoints, we have to set the flag generate debug info for all the PoW we want to use in the debug process. In this case, in the PoW, let's close this one, properties. Okay, in this PoW, I have to stop simulation first. This PoW generate debug info to true, but also the function block generate debug info to true. Build again, start again. Well, this icon reminds that the program is running, since the play is not light. It means that the program is running. Okay, sorry, we can see also from here. Now we can place, or we can set a breakpoint over this block. We expect that the program stops over this block. For now is in pause, in stepping. The yellow arrow points to the next block that will be executed, or the next line in event of text or language that will be executed. So once the program is in pause, we can continue with the step over, so it executes one block after the other. So sooner or later we should, here is this one, and then this one, step, and then next one. While with the step into, it will enter and open or enter in that function block if it is allowed to enter, if it is not protected by password or it is not a block of the standard library. So now I will enter, so step into, it will open there is the code inside the stage 4 direct, and then we can continue with the step into or step over recursively. The red line indicates that we can see the value of the variable, the current value of that variable. So this is off, and so on. Now I can try to press continue, so it will continue till the next breakpoint, that is the first one that we placed. So we have already tested the project, we saw that it works, so there's nothing to fix, nothing to troubleshoot. So I can stop and disable the debug info, also from here. Okay. Well, quick resume. So in this exercise we have replaced these four blocks with a new one called Stage 4 Direct, and with the strategy inside written in with basic ST language. We saw the difference between function and function block, with definition of function block and features. And then we have created a new function block, and we saw the four steps to create a function block. Well, for this exercise, it's all.